So feel free to check out Patreon for the uncut and early reaction, guys. And I hope you enjoy this reaction. Hey guys, Trevor Crudley here today with, and we're back with Scam. Season 2, episode 12. I believe this is the last episode of season 2. And you know what? Season 2 has been one hell of a fun ride. I don't know if I want to react to the bloopers. Do you want me to react to the bloopers? Or is there anything you want to react to me from season 1 and 2 that I haven't reacted to before I jump to season 3? Make sure you let me know. Other than that, no, season 2 has been at the very top. I think season 2 has been a massive improvement over 1. I love Nora and William quite a lot. I just like how the characters acting this season was really good as well. I enjoyed Ava, it's just great. She's such a... I love Ava whenever she's drunk, she's fun. But otherwise, yeah, Nora and William's relationship was definitely a standout. I enjoyed it pretty much every moment of it. The drama was pretty cool. It was quite a down-to-earth season. There wasn't any, like, too... It never went, like, super melodramatic. It always kept that right amount of drama and right amount of trust to it. And then it came up with, like, reasonable sort of situations that make it come up. And yeah, and then it even gave us a bit of insight into the brother that we don't even, like the older brother who I don't like, but they still gave a bit more insight to him, how he like killed his sister in a car crash and stuff like that. So, was it younger brother or younger sister? But overall, really enjoyed the second season. I think the season's been amazing. But yeah, let's jump into the last episode, guys. So if you enjoyed the reaction, leave that like, subscribe. Check out Patreon for the uncut unedited reactions, along with early access to the highlights. And let's jump into this bad boy. You don't have to kill him.
Du har ikke drept den, vel?
Yeah, he's just in the trunk of the car, chilling.
Er det du som har bodd i kjellerboden vår?
Bans. I like she lighting the moon up there a little bit.
Som driver og bor i kjellerboden vår.
Probably be staying with his boy Chris.
I know.
Jeg bodde hos Chris, og jeg kommer fortsatt til å bo hos Chris.
Hey, Chris is his bro, isn't it? Fucking hell.
Du kan bo her også, liksom.
Men... Oh!
En eller...
I wonder what it's like to get film this in front of like 20 people recording and filming it. I gotta give out to props sometimes. It's easier. Fucking Nora pushing him forward. I can't do like that.
Og så må du se han i øya, og så må du si at han en jævla taper.
It's quite weird to think that William is a sort that wants to just keep avoiding this and not confront it. You wouldn't think so when you first met him.
Just
not
think you.
So the solution for this is... That is a very, like, extreme one. Yeah. Go on, my man. Oh. Otherwise, he's just like, he's on this now. This is his new plan. We can move into this apartment. Just add to it. We'll let it go.
Okay.
These shots feel like I'm that the, you know, when they give characters perspective inside of my, it feels like I'm doing that, but without actually giving any words to it. It's pretty impressive. I bet if you added up all the kissing scenes in Scam, you could get a full episode of Scam. I bet someone's done that. Why? I didn't do anything.
Ja, men hvorfor ikke jeg innkalt?
Det sikkert fordi du stakk før politiet kom den kvelden. De tok navnet vårt, og så har det ikke skjedd noe etter det. Men de har kommet over...
Oh yeah, she stormed off, didn't she?
Nå har politiet anmeldt saken selv.
Kan han ekte å si noe, da?
Ja. Ja, altså, we have the right to remain silent.
We have the right to remain silent.
Uansett så kan ikke de dømme han ut fra...
Jeg er penetrate, gutter, og William gjorde ingenting for å hevne seg. Men så banket opp Jonas, og det var Chris og Isak som planla å banke opp Yakuza den rullekvelden.
Fucking the fucking politics going on with these gangs, my god. Fucking Game of Thrones over here.
Men kanskje vi bare
probably have a better storyline than Game of Friends ended with as well.
Jeg tror ikke det er sånn det funker. Altså, de er jo bare interessert i hvem det var som kastet den flasken i hodet på noen.
Can't you just convince the guy whose head got smashed to drop charges? Fucking no. I love how she looks like fully from her point of view now, whereas before she was like dead to the thing against it.
Also, han har jo litt sånn problem med å kontrollere sinnet da. Det må være greit å si det også.
Jeg sier vi holder kjeft i det avhøret.
Enig.
Gang, gang, gang!
Det må ta slutt, ok? Fordi liksom, vi har begynt å få naboklager fra,
yeah, she has
fra de som bor under oss, liksom.
Jeg vet ikke noe om det er.
Yeah, okay, mate. You're a very good liar.
Er det han Tito? Eller?
Det kan hende at det er Linn.
The sash she's giving out.
Det er ditt sengetøy.
Nei, det er det vel ikke.
Ok,
går du rundt og bare vet hva som er sengetøy mitt?
That's how you respond, say, right?
Jeg er den eneste som vasker. Jeg skulle bare ikke drive skift samtalen.
Det
er på grunn av William.
Oh, for fuck's sake. He's the master to change the subject here.
Nei, det er ikke på grunn av William.
Jo, det er det. Jeg ser det på deg. Du begynner å tenke med seksuelle baner. Vet du hva, William?
Mate, stop changing it! He's tried so hard.
Billy. Faen, jeg skal bare... Hold kjeft!
Har dere hatt sex?
Nei!
He's masterful at this.
Vet du hva, dere kommer til å ha det nå. Dere kommer til å ha det så...
He is fucking... Nailing this changing subject! I'm impressed. I can learn from him. Teaching master.
Nei, nå kødder du med meg. Du, ok. Skogtur, gå på Google, søk på skogtur. Jeg lover at det er noe for deg. Du kan se den med William. Det blir sånn folk der.
Ha det, Eskil. Slutt å ha folk boende i kjellet.
Well done, he got himself off the hook like a boss. I should generally impress how he pulled that off.
Eskil, du ikke skal si noe om alt de gjorde. Og da skal heller ikke de si noe om alt du gjorde.
Jesus, charisma. Does she have enough... Whip on him to do it.
Nei. Glem det. Ferdig.
Sure, Yakuza guy should know though, if that sort of favor for a favor thing, if you both don't say anything. Ooh. You tried, Nora. I respect the effort for trying there. Don't be careful with this message. Ooh, Nora's done it. Ooh. What?
Hvorfor har du gjort det?
Vet du faen, jeg er på grunn av det du sa, kanskje?
I'm like, no, now!
Jeg sa jo at du ikke skulle si en dritt. Det var det jeg sa.
Why did you confess? He's so happy about it as well. Did you get let off or something? Yeah, now I've got 5 years in prison, so... That's our last kiss, no.
Det om Nico. Det at vi skulle tro på... Eller stole på det at vi har et ferdig...
No, the legal system can't be trust.
Så bare vant jeg å stole på det.
It's a fucking business at the end in a lot of places.
Alternativt. Kunne jeg valgt å ikke stole på det. Og så... Heller bare holdt kjeft om det.
I love my words. The words pop a stick with some people, don't they?
Hvis du skjønner.
She's low-key like between like being proud of him and like, oh shit. Right, let's try and believe in the legal system, guys. Isaac's looking on point, I give him that. Man's got a bit of style this time. I'm glad the mophead's gone. I'm glad they do the audio perfect, where like there's music, but they like raise their voices above it. It's quite nice. This show's just got a really authentic feel to it, and that's what I really like about it. Look at these guys sexting in the middle of the party. What she sent to announce it. Of course.
Chris, ut.
Are you serious now?
Ut. No.
Oh, he's in the middle of getting it up. Poor Chris. Man was trying. Fucking Chris is eyeing up Casper. She gives such intense things. It's Casper getting in there. Oh, I love Chris. Jokes. Remember when Isaac was getting those looks? Jonas and Isaac proper fashioned up, didn't they? It's Chris and Casper doing it. They... Oh, Chris. Is he trying to eat a face off? Fucking hell, mate. Oh, that is jokes. Oh, that's jokes. He was fucking going for a munch, he was. Fucking hell. Oh. This is a nice way to end off the season. I like this. I like the little idea of a party to end it off. Aw, so cute! I'll go away no one and I don't give a shit.
Thank you, sir.
Now I've got a truth to tell you. Here's a t-shirt and then walks off one of those t-shirts he gave to girls. Oh, Jonas gonna make a move. Where are you seeing someone?
Yeah.
I love the chill conversations. I think the conversations are done so well in this show. Is that it? You know what, that was actually one of my four favourite episodes of the season. I'm glad they went with a more chilled last episode with hardly too much drama. They had a bit of the prison stuff, but otherwise I really enjoyed the fact they just sort of had a bit more chilled drama. Overall, solid season. I enjoyed Nora and Rory's relationship. I think that was definitely a cuter way to end off the show. Really enjoyed this part. One thing Scam Season 2 really nailed is just the interactions between characters. It's so fucking well done. It's not even funny. It's like, you can really tell the woman who did this did her research into teens and how teens would act, and just the way they draw out scenes, just the perfect amount, keep the intenseness going. I think we're all solid in this season. William is probably my favourite character of this season. I enjoyed his story and the perspective he gave. I could probably see why people might not like this season, as it just, if you don't like the main couple, if you don't like Noah or William, you're not going to like this season. But if you do like both of them, I think this is a fantastic season, which luckily I'm glad I like both of them. So that's how it goes with any romance story. If you don't like the other half, you're not a massive fan. You're not going to be a massive fan of them, are you, overall? So started out with many romance anime I've watched. If you don't like this one, the person that's getting shit with, you've screwed it normally. But overall, I liked them both. I really like William, to be fair. I think the side characters were a bit weaker this season, as we didn't really get to see too many of the side characters. I think Sana stood out this season. I actually think Vilda stood out quite well this season as well. I think she had some really cool moments, and just her coming to terms with everything was a really nice little story arc. I think Eva was put on about Boner, but of course that's going to be the case. And then Chris was sort of put on about Boner as well. Hopefully she gets a bit more screen time in next season. I'm looking forward to see what they're going to do next season. I believe it's Isaac's season I know season 3 is Isaac, and I think season 4 is Sana, I think so. So I'm curious to see what they're going to do with season 3, as they've built up some plot points around Isaac, so it's going to be, look forward to see them actually start exploring them a bit more now. But yeah, I've not got too much to say other than that. I really enjoyed that season of Scam. I think that was way better than season 1, and yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed the reactions. If you did, leave a like, subscribe. Hope to see you in the next one. Peace. Thank you for watching the video, guys. As always, I'm much appreciated. Feel free to check out Patreon if you want early access and uncuts. Subscribe to the channel if you want more of this content, along with, I've got a playlist and best match for you. Hopefully you enjoy the content. Continue enjoying the content, guys. And yeah, hope to see you in the next one.